Fresh. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ, that's my DJ. Go DJ. All right, so we'll go over with a quiz review. This section here, Emily's problem, you're allowed to use the calculator here, whether graphing or scientific. I do not care. What's the formula here? Emily invests $4,562 in a saving account with a fixed annual interest rate of 2% compounded continuously. What will be the account balance after 11 years? Shay and Kilbright, you were not here when it did continuously. But what's the formula, guys? The A part, right? That's the formula for continuously. The investment amount is $4,562. That's your initial, 4562. E, the rate is 2%. Don't write 2, but you write 0.02. Are we good with that? In terms of decimal. And the time is 11 years. You can use your calculator for this. 4562, second to the E. 0.02 times 11. What did we get here, guys? The final amount in dollar sign will be 684.60 in 11 years. We're all good with that one, guys. Doable, right? Very good. Move on. Again, we're recording this. So if you want to rewatch it to make sure you understand, you're going to have a test anyway, maybe Monday or Tuesday too. So again, this one here is Paul invests $8,992 in a saving account with a fixed annual interest rate of 2% again, compounded quarterly. Quarterly, how many times is that in a year? 4. So A is equal to, what's the formula we're going to use? P 1 plus R over N raised to the NT. Are we good with that? Yeah. And what is our P? The initial amount is 8992. 1 plus the rate is 0.02. The compounded quarterly means 4. And 4 times how many years? After 4 years. Punch in your calculator, 1 plus 0.02, divide by 4, raised to 16. What do you get, guys?
9,738.98.
Very good. In 4 years. We're good with this, guys. Okay? All right, next, graphing. This is exponential function. First thing that you should know is to draw the table. Negative 1, 0, 1. This 1 over b, 1 and b. Do you agree? But what's the base here? 1 half. I forgot to remind you, I know you all know, if the base is 1 half, is that growth or decay?
Decay.
Decay, because it's between 0 to 1. Are we good? Anything bigger than 1 is growth. But since the base here is 1 half, I'll put here, what's 1 divided by half?
2.
We're all good with that? Everybody knows that this is 2? Mm-hmm. You divide a dollar by 50, so there are 2 of that, right? So this will be 2. This will be 1, and then the 1 is going to be half. Are we good with that one? Now, minus 2 tells you to do what? You're going to shift the graph to the
right
by 2. So what are you going to do here? You're going to add 2 to the x. Good job. You're going to add 2 to the x here. So I'm going to add two here, add two there, add two there. Are we all good with that? Now, here's the next. I have a minus 4 and a negative 1 there. Should I subtract 1 or multiply by negative 4 first? Multiply first. Remember the rule, the PEMDAS. Multiply first before you subtract. So multiply 4, negative 4 to the y. And then after that, you will subtract 1. So times 4, negative 4, I mean times negative 4, times negative 4. Are we good? Whatever the product, you subtract by 1, subtract 1, subtract 1. Understood? Understood.
Which one does, so how do you know whether it changes to x or y? Wait, no, never mind. I get it.
This only time you do the x.
Yeah.
So therefore, the final table for us right now would be 2 minus 1 is 1. This is 2. That's 3. What's 2 times negative 4? Minus 1. 1 times negative 4. Negative 4 minus 1 is negative 5. This will give you negative 2 minus 3. Am I right? Did you get the same table, guys? Now we plot the points. 1, negative 9, right here. 2, negative 5, right here. And 3, negative 3, right there. We're all good. Now, the very last number is always your what? No.
Or your asymptote.
The asymptote. The last one is your friend zone. So HA is Y is equal to negative 1. When we did the game yesterday, a lot of you neglected that. That should be the fastest question that you can do. Remember? I was waiting. A lot of you did not pay attention to that one. That's always the asymptote. So you know the graph will not cross this. Or we get closer to this dotted line here. Billion. This gets closer there, and this keeps going up there. We're good with that?
How is negative 3 minus 1 negative? Wait.
I erased the word already. Want to go back?
No, it's okay. Can you go back? No, it's fine. It's fine.
Or you know what, you can go back with the video now. Is that right? Oh, okay, okay, Lopez. Of course. Are you going back just to copy?
No, I'm trying.
Yeah.
Why'd you get negative 9 from the first one?
2 times negative 4 is?
Oh, no, okay. I got it. Thank you.
Are you with me now? Are you sure, Lopez?
Yes.
Final answer?
Yes.
Good. It's your dotted line and it's your graph. We're all good? So what's next? What is our domain here and range?
Is there no vertical asymptote?
Huh?
Is there no vertical
asymptote? No, ma'am.
Why?
Why? Because there's none on this topic because there's nothing, this has no limit. It keeps going okay. Further to the left.
Okay.
And this keeps going further to the right. Okay. The domain here is? The range? Bracket parenthesis. What else am I missing? Intercept. This is where the problem starts. Do we have x-intercept? No, because it will not cross the x-axis there, right? Do we have a y-intercept?
Yeah.
Most likely. It shows on the graph. It might not be accurate, but let's get it. How do you find the y-intercept?
0
to where? So negative 4, 1 half, 0 minus 2 minus 1. 0 minus 2 is? What's 1 half negative 2? That will become 4. Do you agree? Are we clear that that's 4? What's negative 4 times 4? Minus 1. So therefore, this should have been A, should have been B, and the graph here is not accurate, so it should cross negative and B there. So the graph should go this way here. We're good with that one, guys. So the intercept loop 0, comma, negative 17. I'm gonna add EB. What's EB stands for? End behavior. As X approach where?
Positive.
If you go positive infinity, it goes to the right. What's happening to your f of X? Where is the f of X approaching to the right side? Negative 1. Good job. As X approach to the left, that should be?
Negative
infinity. What's happening to my f of X?
Negative
infinity, right? As you go to the left, the graph dips down. What else am I missing? Is it? That's it. Describe the transformation. What happened there? It went to the where? Transformation. It went where?
Right to.
Down one. There's more. Reflect over where? X axis. There's one more. Growth or decay? Decay. Huh? The four. What does the four does? It's a VST. A VSF, I mean. Vertigo, stretch, with a factor of how much? 4, not negative. The negative is for the reflecting over the x-axis. Yes, ma'am?
For the domain, like, why does it work? Oh, wait, never mind. Anna? Why is it okay?
Because of 1 half. The base here is between 0 and 1.
But what does decay look like?
Decay looks like going down. But since it's negative, it reflects over the x-axis. The orange one is reflecting to the pink one. You see it? It flipped over because it's negative 4 there. Negative. Yes, ma'am?
If there was a negative inside the parentheses, would it flip the other way then?
No, the base cannot be negative.
Okay.
The base has to be a positive number. We're all good? You have any question? Move on. I'll teach you the log as we learn this one here. We haven't done log. Oh, there's more here. Oh, I didn't see that. So the final point I would like to see on your paper, I should be this one here. This is what I'm going to look if you have that. We're good? I will make sure, and I did. I was telling the girls a while ago, I know already what to put in the quiz, and I didn't, like, there's nothing there will be, like, needed for a calculator. You can all do it without calculator. Okay, next, let me do now the log. We learned it, we haven't done it, we're gonna learn it now. Log. Everyone, look at the board. What's the base?
The 1/4.
1/4. If in the exponential, we always start with negative 1, 0, 1, right? What do you know about exponential and log? They are what? Inverse. Whoever said a good job, inverse. Inverse means to you swap the what? The x and the y. If this is what we use with the exponential, in the log, we swap them. This becomes a negative 1, 0, 1. And this is a 1 over b. This is a 1, this is a b. You see what happened? You just swap their position. Understood? If in the, I think I messed up now. My brain is working. If in number 4, I put, good thing, thank you. I put their H, A, D, A, right? In number 4 and 6. In number 4, there's no V, A, like what Shay said. In number 6, there's no H, A, but there's a V, A. Does it make sense? It's always one or the other, okay? So, let me go back. Where's the table? There we go. All right, so in number five, it's a log, there will be no HA. Are we clear? Okay, but there will be a VA. Let's do the table first. What is our base here? Negative 1, 0, 1. It's going to be 1 and 1 fourth. This will be 1, this will be 4. I don't know, I'm wrong. This will be 1 fourth, right? Okay, what's 1 divided by 1 fourth?
4.
So this will be 4, this will be 1, this is 1 fourth. Are we clear with that? Okay, now, what does the x plus 4 do? Shift to the left, right, up or down? Left, left by? So what are you going to do? Minus 4 to where? The x. So I'm going to subtract 4 here. Subtract 4 here, subtract 4 there. Make sense? We're good? And what I do with the plus 2?
You add it to the 1.
You're going
to
add 2 here, add 2 there, add 2 there. We're all good with that. Yes or no? Am I fast?
No, not really. Just the first part, that you did, I was confused.
Did you get it now?
Yeah, you just swapped that.
Should it? Mm-hmm. Are we good with that?
Yeah, I'll look back at you.
What's negative 4? What's 4 minus 4?
Zero.
The table, I'm going to write my table here, okay? I don't have space there. So 4 minus 4 is 0. Negative 4 plus 1 is negative 3. Negative 4 minus 1 fourth. Negative 4 minus or plus 1 fourth. What do you do there?
Negative
3. Negative 3 fourths. We're good with that one?
Yeah.
We're good? I'm not going to give it like a 17 or a 26, something like that. No, I'll keep it that you can do the fraction in your head. Are we good? Okay. Negative 1 plus 2?
1.
0 plus 2?
0.
1 plus 2?
3.
We're all good with that one. Okay. Let's draw the table here. 0, 1. 0, 1 is right here. Negative 3, 2 is up here. Negative 3, 2 is up here. Negative 3 fourths is a little bit old between negative 3 and 4. Up 3. You agree, guys? Looks like there's something wrong. No, it's right. No, you're right. We're good. Everything's good. Everything's good.
I have a question.
Yes.
Why are you adding 2 and not multiplying it by 2?
Because it says there plus 2.
But in the 1 before you...
That's exponential number 1. Number 2 to the negative 4 is in front of the base.
Okay.
We're good? And there's a minus 1 after that, that's why you subtract 1.
Okay.
Good? So, how do we get the asymptote here? The asymptote here will be the x plus 4. You're going to solve for the x there. X plus 4, dang it, it goes 0. No, it's not that. I have an ugly penny. Okay. Minus 4 here. I'm not going to be the... What's the value of the x there? What? Negative. What is that negative 4 stands for? What is that? That's your?
Asymptote.
It's where the asymptote. You can see, guys, you can see the dot. The dots are all going to the negative 4. Can you see it?
Is that how you determine whether it's vertical or horizontal?
For long, it's always vertical.
Okay.
This gets closer there. This keeps going. Okay. Lana, come on, give it away. What do we do next? Find the, what is this point here?
Y-intercept.
So your y-intercept is already 0, 1. What, do we have x-intercept here?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, it will cross at some point. How do you find the x-intercept?
0,
0 to the y. This is where we might be the challenge here, guys. To get the x-intercept, 0 for the y is equal to log of 1 fourth x plus 4 plus 2. Now, everybody pay attention here. This is a struggle now. I mean, not really hard, but it's just like you have never seen like this so far. I'll move the 2 first to the left. This becomes negative 2 equals log of 1 fourth x plus 4. Any question with the pink and black work? We're all good?
Yes.
If you're my kid, I'll tell you, if you didn't know what to do, always change it to exponential form or log form. What we have here on the board right now is log form, right? Can you convert them into exponential form? What's the exponential form? What's the base? 1/4?
To the negative 2.
Is equal to x plus 4. Are we all good with that one?
Yeah.
What's 1/4 to the negative 2? Remember, that's negative. If this goes up, this becomes positive. Do you agree? If this goes up, this becomes positive, right?
Yeah.
So it becomes 4 to the positive squared, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's equal to x plus 4. What's 4 squared? 16. Patience. X equal to 12. So your x-intercept is? Would you agree that this one here, look at the graph, guys, here on the board. Do you think this blue graph should have crossed 12? Right? Okay. So I'm going to this would have been, keep going, maybe 12, somewhere there. 12, the same side there. Are you with me?
Mm-hmm.
And the rest should be decent from there. Domain is will be what? What's the domain here?
Negative
4 parenthesis to the infinity. What's the range here? Very good. Look at the answer in number 4. The domain. What's the domain number 4? All real numbers. Look at the answer in number 5. Where's the all real numbers?
Range.
They swap, right? And they ask about swap. Okay? So be mindful about what else am I missing?
The transformation.
Huh? Transformation. This is transformation. Transformation here. What happened? We slide to the left 4. Right? The base is 1/4. Growth or decay?
Decay.
There's a plus 2. We went up by 2. That's it. There's no number outside the log, so that means it's not vertical stretch or compression. Are we all good with that?
Mm-hmm.
Next.
Okay.
Oh, go ahead. Question. Intercepts are already here, right?
What's the end behavior.
Thank you for that. Good. End behavior. As x approaches to the left side, what is happening to the graph? If you're going to the left, what happened? You're approaching what? What? The f of x is approaching negative 4. Do you agree? As the x goes to the right, where are you going? Positive or negative? Negative. Sorry, guys, my pen.
Don't you
stop.
Like, shouldn't it be as x approaches negative 4
as x goes to the left? As x goes to the left, as x goes to the left, no, you're right. I'm wrong there. Hold on. Thank you. Hold on. Hold on, go back. Let's see. If you go to the left, yours approaching. No, I know what you're talking about. Hold on. If you go to the right, you're going down.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are going to the left, what?
Wouldn't you be going to negative 4?
You're saying that this has to be negative 4?
Yeah.
Hold on.
As x goes to negative 4, y.
The graph is going up. Yeah, I get that makes sense. Hold on. If you go to the left, it's negative 4 here. Very good. And this one here is approaching positive, right? It's going up. And here, as you go down, no, this is positive. This is going
negative.
No, that's right. Robert?
Yeah.
Are you here? Good. Next. Question number 7. And by the way, let's make it 4 here. All right, some of you came this morning. I'm happy. I hope I'm able to give them a little light or a light to the situation here. My thing here is always, can you convert them to... Okay, hold on. Let me repeat. If you can do it in your head, that's good. If you can do it in your brain, that's good. But not everybody is as fast as you are, right? So my thing there, always convert them into exponential form. Example, look at number 10 here. Let's go with number 10 first. How can I convert this to exponential form if I don't have other side of the equation? So I tell them, just set it equal to x on your own. On your own. Can you convert this to exponential form, please? What's the exponential form here? What's the base?
3.
To the?
X.
Is equal to?
1/9.
Your goal is to make them same base. 9 is same thing as what? 9 is same thing as? 3 squared. Do you agree? We're good? But the square, the 3 squared is on the bottom. I need to bring it? If I bring it up, it should be what? 3 to the negative 2. Now, do they have the same base? Cancels the 3, so the answer for x is equal to negative 2. We're good with that? Yes or no? We're good? So let's go to 7 here. Ray, set it equal to x. What's the base?
64.
To the?
X.
Is equal to? Your goal is to make their base the same. 64 is same thing as? 4 to the? X, because the x is existing there. This 4 will go up, but it will be 4 to the negative 1. Do they have the same base? Cancel it. So you know you have 3x equal to negative 1. So the value of x is equal to how much? Negative 1/3. Are we good with that one, guys? Okay.
Wait, how did you know to move the...
You have to figure out to make their bases the same.
Yeah.
That's why I have to bring it up to make it 4, not 1/4.
Okay.
We're good?
I guess.
You guess.
It's weird. The next one's like that too.
It's not. Okay. Equal to x. So therefore, Jacob, 3 to the?
3x.
Is equal to?
243.
How many times do you need to multiply 3? To get 343. Five times.
What if you
Then, memorize your multiplication table.
Okay.
That's why you their portion, I have to keep it below maybe 200. We're good?
Mm-hmm.
All right. What's the answer for 9? 9, negative 3, negative 2, 5, and what's that one? Negative 1/3. I think I can skip that one. I can give you the answer for this. 11. Evaluate. How many times do you need to multiply 6 to get to 16?
3.
How many times do you need to multiply 7 to get 343? 3. We're good. That's how you do it in your brain. Okay, rewrite. This should be the basic part. Rewrite this to exponential form. Shay, you were here yesterday. What's the base, Shay?
36.
To the? 1/2. Is equal to?
6.
Good job. Kilbride, what's the base?
14.
To the? Is equal to?
342.
No, we're number 14, my friend. 196. This is a gimme, right? Good. Next, Nate, to make sure we got something tomorrow. Nate, help me here. Convert the log form. Log, what's the base, sir?
Y.
Y, what's the answer?
X.
And that is equal to?
-4 or 5.
Do you agree, guys? Okay. Daniel, log, what's the base? What's the answer?
19.
And that's, and the exponent is?
Okay,
we're all good with that one, guys.
All right. That's all we have to do for
it. Yes, you're writing. Okay. Solving part. Solving. What's the invisible base here?
10.
And Mr. L, I couldn't think of a number. If the base is 10, the answer will be negative 2. Convert it. If you do not know what to do, always convert to exponential form. What's the base here again? 10 raised to the is equal to b. Jordan, what is 10 to the negative 2? If you have a negative exponent, what happened? It dropped. It goes down. It changed the position. So this will go down. So it will be how much now? 1 over 10 squared. It's going to be positive now, right? Equals b. What is 10 squared? So 1 over 100. Make sense?
So you do.
Yes. Now, you're asking this to me. Mr. O, how can I do this one without calculator if there's an E? Everybody pay attention here. This is an ACP question. LN. What do you know about the base of LN? E. You know it's the same thing as log E K equals 4. Do you agree? The choices there have no decimal value. What is the value of k here? Convert this again to where? Exponential form. This has been trying to. What's the x base here? E 4 is equal to? Did you able to solve for the k? So the answer is e to the 4. There's no need to use calculator for that. Make sense? We're all good? So if you have a no calculator section, there's an E in gold or LN, you keep it as in the letter E. Like a pi, like 3 pi, you know, which we're about to learn and trick after this chapter. Move on. All right, I think I can rest tomorrow. I don't have to come to school. I teach a lot here. What's the base here?
2.
What's the exponent? Is equal to x. Again, one more time. The young. If we have a negative exponent, what happened? Goes down. So what's the answer? Is equal to x. Kaboom. Are you good with that? Cunningham, what's the base? To the? Is equal to? What's 9 to the 0? Any number raised 0 is always equal to?
1.
What's the answer? By the way, that's wrong statement. What did your teacher last year, except me, told you about 0?
My teacher last year said that it'd be 1.
Yes, but back in the days when I was... It's not always true. Because 0 to the 0 is not equal to 1. It's not the final. Okay? But beside from 0, any number raised 0 is equal to 1.
Oh, okay.
Just imagine all the math nerds get together and they find for loopholes in math. And that's one of the things. All right, we're all good?
Wait, so if they ask you, like, on the ACT or the SAT, are you supposed to put, like, if they ask you that, you just, like...
I don't think they will ask you that. But if they do, it's not the final. Try to use your calculator. Try it. I'm curious. 0 to 0. What's the answer? And if I write, X, what was the last number? Oh, the word problem. Okay, I guess I can give you the answer for some of this.
I guess.
121, are we good?
Yeah.
And 1 over 81, we're good with that? Okay. All right. This is the last two. I'm not there.
That was confusing.
Okay, because you haven't learned it. Okay? Eli, read the problem, please.
Carlos invests $5,535 in a retirement account with a fixed annual interest rate of 9% compounded continuously.
False! What's the compounded continuously, George? Good job. Continue, sir.
How long will it take for the account balance to reach $21,350.85?
The question is how long? We're looking for what? Time. You know the final amount is $21,350.85, right?
Yeah.
It's equal to, what's the principal? $5,535. What's the rate?
0.09
T. Are we all good with that?
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
I need you to pause and watch me here. Get an order. Divide this by how much? Your goal here is to isolate the T. Are we all clear with that?
Yeah.
I need to divide it by 5535. 5535. This cancel out. Are we all good? Of course, the word problem requires you to use calculator. Are we all good? Okay. This gone, that's gone. Whatever is that one, okay. Can I write this in the parentheses? So I stop, I don't have to write this number all the time. Whatever is that is in parentheses is equal to 0.09 T. Are we all good with that? Convert this to log form. Because you don't know what to do, convert to log form. Are we good? That's why if you are my daughter, son, I will tell you, if you're stuck, always convert to exponential or log form. Depends on what's given to you. Here what's given to you is exponential form, then convert to log form. Are we good? That's number still there. What is the log form here? What's the base? Log? What's the base?
E.
Whatever the answer is equal to 0.09 T, right? The one inside the parentheses is the quotient when I divide this two. I don't have a calculator with me right now, but you know what I mean there. We're good? But what is log with a base of E? Ln. I can look at the board, please. I can replace this one here by ln. Do you agree with me?
Yeah.
I will erase this one here. So I'll erase it. I guess you're watching the video right now. Ln of the answer is equal to 0.09. Are we all good? Okay. Divided by the entire thing. The entire ln of that divided by 0.09. And that will give you the time. Let me show it to you in the calculator here. Excuse me, guys. So make sure that you have reference. Sorry, I have so much things. What? Oh. Calculator. All right. Tell me, please. All right, second plus 712. Always clear the memory. Ln, where's the ln? Beside the 4. Ln of what? What was the problem there? 21,000. One more time. 350, ma'am?
0.85? Yes.
Thank you. Divided by, what was the initial amount? 5535. Close. Here's the common mistake. Some of you might hit their divided by 0.09. Every calculator might work differently. If you're my kid, I'll tell you to press enter first. And then divided by, what is the rate? 0.09. See what happened? My fast, repeat. Enter. What do you get? Obviously, 14.99 is equal to 15. 15?
Years.
Years, thank you. 15 years. Anyhow, good. All right. One last year.
Wait.
Yes, go back.
If you just like, if you simplified it before, like.
There might be discrepancy.
No, I mean like, if you got the, if you divided the big numbers together at the beginning, and then could you put it into the LN?
Yes. And then divided by the rate. Yes, you're right. I just showed you how to get it from there. That's why. All right, we're good. Anna, and the rest. Last one here. I can rest now. Not forever. My kids still need me. All right. Lopez, read the problem, please.
Jenny invests $4,119 in a savings account with a mixed annual interest rate of 7%, compounded semi-annual.
What do you mean a semi-annual?
Twice
a year. Good. What's the formula we're going to use here, Gilbride? A is equal to B. Plus. We're good there, Gilbride. Remember this from 2 days ago? Go ahead. Keep reading, ma'am.
How long will it take for the account balance to reach 21,350?
Oh, no. Not
21. How long will it take for the account balance to reach $8,195.94?
Where do we write the 8,195.94? $8,195.94. This equal to how much? What's the P?
4,000.
4,000. Time check. Okay. 4,119. 1 plus, what's the rate? 0.07 over 2. 2 times P. Are you that? My suggestion here, simplify this part first, the parentheses. So get your calculator. Again, you will be allowed to use calculator here. 1 plus 0.07 divided by 2. What do you get, guys? Okay, and then make sure you divide this by how much? You divide always the principal, the final amount by the principal. This cancels out. You want to get rid of that all the time. Bless you.
Thank
you. So whatever this inside the parentheses, it's equal to, what goes here, guys? What do you get here? 1.035 to the 2t, right? 2t. When you don't know what do you do again for the millionth time? What? I see mumbling. What do you do? Convert to what? Log. Good job. Log. What's the base? Thank you. 1.035. What's the answer? Is it equal to 2t? Now here is the problem. How can I get that one, Mr. O? 2t. So you need to get the answer here on the green one. And whatever the answer there, you will divide it by 2. Mr. O, how can I get that answer? Get your calculator, please. That's why it is important that you have a calculator here, because I can't do this in my head. Back when I was in high school, we have a paper. We look for the chart all the time. Here's the basis, often the basis. Here are the log number. You match it. It's like a matrix. We don't have this calculator when I was in high school. But anyway, let's move forward here. What do I do? So you have a copy of this? Mm-hmm. What do you do? There you go. All right. First, what is the value of the final amount? 8,100 what? 95.94 divided by how much?
4.19.
Enter. That's the amount, right? That's the quotient, right? Real good. Here's what you need to do. Okay? You should have, where is that one, Dart? Help me, Dart. Alpha y, right? Then function. There you go. Thank you.
I just clicked math.
Okay. So, yeah, maybe math will work.
Can you go down? Go down.
Blood base. Right? Hold on. Let me figure out first, okay? Okay, and then this, that's not, no. Okay, first. Repeat. Alpha. Window. Write on your paper. Alpha window, then 5. See the log base? Enter. So now you're just gonna punch in the entire question. What is the base that we have there? 1.035. And what was our quotient a while ago? No, let me just put everything. 8,000. Tell me the final amount.
1.94.
Ah, dang it. It's recorded. Sorry, sugar. All right, divided by 4,119. There you go. Are we all following? This equal to what? Equal to 2t. Remember the 2t? So enter here. Whatever is that one divided by 2. So how many years?
10 years.
Okay, now here's the problem. Those people who have an older calculator, it won't work. You have the 83? You don't have this thing. Okay, I'll give you another way. Those... How many of you have the older version that it didn't work? 1, 2, only 2 people, then I got you. There's another way. There's always a way. How do you do it, Larry? Help me. Here, where's the pen? Log. What's your, Eli and Jacob? Again, 8,195. I'm just going to type in the question, 0.94 divided by, that's not what. 8,195.94 divided by 4,119. It's too much. Jacob, are we good there, Jacob? And Eli, that's the numerator. Log of that. Divided by Jacob, log of the base. 1.035. And I can tell you, Jacob and Eli, if I press enter here, the answer will be 19.99. Good? Are good there? That's another formula because you don't have the newer version. Okay? We're good? All right, I think we covered everything here.